outside because we were out late having fun. We were teenagers, okay? But as soon as I opened my car door, now we both seen it, but I noticed that it was moving, and then she did too. I'm like, it's getting closer. She was like, yeah, that car is moving. But as soon as I opened my door, it sped up. So I shut my door. She said, you know, we both was like in sync with that shit. I shut my door. She was saying it as I was doing it, and then she like, off. And we were like hauling ass around my neighborhood, drove all the way down 65th Avenue, up to Old North Road, going Broadway, everything. We tried to lose this fucking car, could not fucking lose it at all. Motherfucker was going on our ass trying to ram us. And yeah, I could not get dropped off for crazy ex-boyfriend that was the abusive one that I was with at the time. That was like, oh yeah, he's playing. It's all cute and shit. No, that fucker was fucking dangerous and crazy as fuck. It was my dumbass, you know, always trusting and giving a bit of a doubt. Didn't recognize that trusting meant, hey, trust a person for who they are. Which means he showed you what he was. And you just thought he was fucking lame. Trust what you saw. Trust what you were shown. Anyway, so yeah, I'm about to go and get some gas for the truck. I'm gonna put some gas here. So when we finally lost him and she pulled in front of my house again, what ended up happening was I had to climb my fence, the 6-foot fence that leads to the back of the house, and I had to go in the house, keep off all the lights, and stay low. And I just called her up to make sure she was all right. The car found her while she was driving off. And she lost it as she was like going underneath the Tacoma. Is it Tacoma? You know, where they play in the damn water and everything. I'm close up. That leads up to like where the freaking Adams. She lost him around that area, and then she hurried up and got on the boulevard and took her ass home, okay, back up to Pensacola. I was never used to no shit like that, but like I said, I started, you know, staying in places where I wasn't from and dealing with people, dating, let me get that straight, dating people. I remember I was walking down the street one time, and this is when I was walking to the laundromat, or from the laundromat, with the ex crazy guy, and I ran into an ex, my first boyfriend ever. I was with him, and so he stopped and started talking to me, and I could feel my ex. He was like, oh, not my ex. I could feel the guy that was dating, the abusive dude. He was like really pissed that I was talking to him, and I was like so covertly trying to signal help me without being too loud, because yeah, the dude I was with Yeah, I was held down by him. He covered my mouth and started beating the shit out of me while we were in the bedroom alone, and told me if I ever left him, he was going to kill me if it wasn't for somebody that was like rich or famous or some shit. Crazy ass people. You too, thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. to relationship to relationship, and everybody else is a fucking crazy one, and everybody else is a goddamn problem. Like I said, yeah, I know some toxic situations and relationships, you know, that I've had and that I was put in. Like I said, the freaking abusive ass person that I was with when I was, when I was like 18 and everything, when I was with that, I thought he was playing. I didn't have experience, okay? I didn't understand that, oh, okay, this isn't just, you know, some sort of game. I didn't know, you know, and that's when I realized, oh, those are signs to watch out for, okay? So I watched out for that shit.
What happened?
47. Okay, have a good day. Bye-bye.